In a typical development environment where applications or microservices are built, multiple developers contribute every day with several changes in code to implement new features, fix bugs, or add patches. These contributions must be placed in a source code control system, which in our demo will be GitHub. This system is the one in charge of handling and merging the contributions from the developers. However, in the process of building an application, there are many more steps. The code has to be compiled, tested on different levels, and it has to be ensured that it doesn't break the legacy application and that the new contributions add value. So, to orchestrate all these activities, Jenkins X is the perfect tool, especially if we are building applications or microservices for Kubernetes. Jenkins X will compile our code, test our application, and create a proper package, which will be hosted by Helm, an application package manager running on top of Kubernetes. Finally, Jenkins X will also deploy our application to our Kubernetes cluster, either for running more tests in a staged area or finally to production. Having a deeper look to what will be happening in the Kubernetes cluster, Jenkins X will typically deploy our application. And the goal of our demo is to secure this or any other application by adding automatically a FortiWeb container protecting it. This is done by modifying the stages in Jenkins X pipeline so that the Kubernetes is instructed to deploy the FortiWeb with the proper services and fully configured. This way, our application is secure even during the early development phases, and the steps to secure it are properly stated in text files with what is called infrastructure and security as code. This demo will work with a very simple application in Python, which is implementing a basic HTTP server that will return the Jenkins logo via HTTP. Aside from the Python code, the container has to be built, and for that there is a Dockerfile specification that instructs our Jenkins server how to build the image. This is the Jenkins console that shows our project and the three different pipelines that we have. One of them is used to build our application, and the others are for promoting the build to the staging or production areas. We will build our application now. A pipeline can implicitly call other pipelines, and actually this one will trigger another to promote the application that we are building to the staging area, in case the process of building the image finishes successfully. Now that Jenkins has built our microservice or application, we will check that it's properly deployed into our Kubernetes cluster in Google Cloud Platform, also known as GKE. If we check the list of workloads, we can see that there is a new pod containing our application. Also, having a look to the services, we see that there is a new Ingress resource that allows to send traffic directly from outside to the application. If we click on it, we can access our new application built and deployed in our Kubernetes cluster. Note that in this case, there is no FortiWeb and traffic is sent directly to the application without any security analysis or filtering. Now we want to add security to our application by having a FortiWeb automatically deployed as part of the continuous deployment process. So to do that, we have added a new stage to this pipeline that will be asking Kubernetes to deploy a pod with FortiWeb. The file that specifies how the FortiWeb must be deployed is also included here as part of the instructions for Kubernetes. As you can see, it is composed of a service that will allow traffic to management port of FortiWeb, another one for allowing user traffic directly into HTTP port of FortiWeb, and of course the part that specifies the deployment itself of the FortiWeb. Also, FortiWeb must be configured automatically, and its configuration is located in this template that will be properly instantiated at deployment time. Now that we have added FortiWeb to the deployment, we are going to rebuild our application to observe that FortiWeb is deployed along. As you can see, a new stage has been added whose name is Deploy FortiWeb, and it will be executed after the others. After the build has finished, if we go back to our GCP console and check out the workloads, we can see that the FortiWeb appears now, together with the application, which is deployed following the usual procedure. An important point is to have our devices configured automatically, avoiding any manual intervention. To access FortiWeb's console and check that the automated configuration went OK, we can obtain the IP and port of the management service for FortiWeb. Using this data in a browser gives access to our management console. First, we have to check that there is a policy allowing HTTP traffic. P1 seems to be OK, as it has a virtual server and server pool already defined, and it's intended for HTTP traffic. Virtual server is also present, and the same happens for server pool, which has internally defined a server whose IP and port matches the one of our application. Again, we repeat the same test as before. We get the ingress URL and access our application. The difference now is that FortiWeb is between ingress and our application and is analyzing the traffic. Please note that for this test, ingress has been modified to send the traffic now to FortiWeb, as you can see in Kiali by checking the flow.